everyone, it's Pumpkin the Kawaii Witchling. It is so hot in Japan. Every day is 98 to 100 degrees. Help! So you guys should be careful and remember to drink water wherever you are. Dehydration and heat stroke are so scary. I remember several weeks ago, I was lost in the heat and so dizzy and I couldn't figure out where I was. So yeah, remember to always hold a drink with you so you stay hydrated. Anyways, today is part 2 of my self-care witch series. I'm so glad you guys enjoyed the last one because I'm having fun too. Even though it takes kind of a long time to make, but I'm having a lot of fun with it. So our first witch is this really sweet, down-to-earth kitchen witch. So kitchen witchcraft is essentially when you incorporate magic into your cooking and eat it to get some effect. For example, you banish illness or you cast a good luck spell. They say that what makes food good is putting your heart into it, and I totally believe it. Plus magic, of course. Food is really powerful in that it can comfort us and make us happy when we're feeling in the dumps. Not to mention that it gives us our nutrition for the day. Food is super important! So because of this, I've portrayed this witch as a laid-back kind of guy who's not afraid to make cute and pretty food and wear a cute apron. Also, I didn't want to make him wear those archaic ritual robes like the previous witches, because most of us that do kitchen witchcraft are just in our daily wear anyway, even on our pajamas. So here he is in all his relaxed glory. You may be wondering what those little guys are around him, and they are creatures that like to watch him cook. The little fairy on his shoulder yelling at him reminds me of when I bake and I feel some presence behind me staring with curiosity. So the story is, one of my fairy friends, so I'll call her Kay, she likes to bake together and we like to enjoy sweets afterwards. So Kay always seems to know when I'm baking and she tags along for some sweets and fruit. Which reminds me, if you guys are working with fairies or you want to work with fairies, fairies really enjoy receiving sweets, baked sweets, also fruit and tea as offerings. So in order to bond, you can give them offerings such as these and just spend quality time together and learn magic together. A lot of entities and spirits actually like these kinds of offerings, so just ask what they like and you can give it to them. Anyway, it's kind of sad, but I have been staying in a temporary living place until the pandemic is over, so our oven is seriously really tiny and I can't bake much, but I've baked a few cookies while staying here. And I'm so excited to move because the place I'm moving to has a full-sized oven that they rarely use. So booyah! I'm so excited! I don't have any specific recipes, I do only for spell work, but whenever I do cook, which is not very often, admittedly, I try to incorporate energies that are associated with the ingredients and also stir in the direction of my intent. So this is clockwise for bringing something to you and counterclockwise to send something away or to banish something. This week I made a tomato sauce pasta with bell pepper, garlic, onion, and also fried eggplant, or you could call it tempura. All of these ingredients have magical properties, so I urge you to look them up if you're interested in kitchen witchcraft. Oh yeah, and I also tried to make watermelon popsicles for Akira since it's summer and he is a butt and isn't drinking enough water, but it didn't really work because our tiny freezer just, it doesn't get cold enough to freeze. It just kind of fell apart and was this goopy mess. I don't know, watermelon juice with extra pulp, but Akira seemed to like it. He always likes watermelon, so he just must have thought, oh boy, extra cold watermelon. Anyway, the original recipe called for yogurt and watermelon, but since Akira can't have dairy, I just left out the yogurt. Maybe you guys can try it out for your doggies though. I'll leave it down in the description and tell me if you try it out and if your doggies like it. And this is our finished kitchen witch. Isn't he adorable? I may be a bit biased with the pretty flowers and creatures, but please tell me guys if you do kitchen witchcraft and what foods you like to make, magical or not. I'd love to cook and bake more, so please drop them recipes! P.S. There are no sigils in this video because I don't really make sigils in my cooking, but you totally can. For example, when you bake bread, you can make a design by scoring it with a toothpick or making it with vegetables or some kind of sauce. You could also do that with pancakes and whatnot. To learn more about kitchen witchcraft, you can follow The Green Witch here on YouTube, and on Instagram, you can look up Wiccan Cuisine. So I found this person very recently, and they show a lot of cool recipes that have magical properties. One recipe that I really want to make from them right now is this harvest sunflower. It looks so good with all the cheese and pumpkin seeds. So if you ate this, it would be really great for harvesting solar energy and just celebrating the sun and the summer season. Right now is Leo season, so you can channel a lot of those glamorous Leo energies for the end of the summer. And I'm kind of getting a little hungry just thinking about it, so we'll go on to our next witch, which is an essential oil witch. So I'm cheating a little bit here, because he is the last witch for today, but he has two forms, just like the crystal witch. So the essential oil witch looks kind of hilarious in the beginning, because these past few years, essential oils have become one of those hot items that MLM companies like to sell. These companies like to insist that oils are the cure-all for anything and can be extremely annoying when they suggest buying their oils to someone who may, for example, have a chronic condition and have tried everything under the sun. I don't even have a chronic condition, but I have been roped into these so-called parties to buy similar products from these companies. I just really don't like these companies and how they prey on really unsuspecting people who just want to have an easier way to make money. For example, if they are a stay-at-home parent. Yeah, I just don't want to support these industries, even though I feel really bad for the people that they rope in. Because of this kind of company, not just oil, but with any mass-produced product, they can be made unethically and just produce a really unsatisfactory item that may not smell great or be as concentrated as they claim, and then you pay a price that doesn't fit the product. It would probably smell not as great and it would greatly affect your spell work and scam you out of your money. The sad thing is, essential oils can be really helpful and amazing, super relaxing, and they have some medical properties. But no, Linda, they are not going to cure cancer! So please, please don't push them on people that say they don't want it. Because of this, I portrayed this witch as this suave, good-looking, but kind of bizarre businessman who only cares about money. And he maintains his good looks because he knows he can use them to sell more products. However, the interesting thing is that he is also a witch and he uses these oils in his witchcraft practice, like here in his money spell and glamour spell. How funny would it be if you walked into your boss's office only to find him doing a money spell on his desk to find more clients this quarter? If you guys want to know one money spell that I have used before, there is a great one from Indigo Priestess that for some reason goes by a different name on YouTube. I think it's still here, but I'll leave a link below. And the video that I found is slightly different from the one that I recorded down in my Book of Shadows. Anyway, it requires one green candle, one silver coin, eucalyptus oil or mint oil, cinnamon, paper, and a pen. So this pen should preferably be green to manifest those abundance, wealth, energies to you. So what you do is write the amount you desire on the paper and fold the paper towards you 3 times to bring the money in. Then you want to make 3 notches or nicks in the candle at the bottom with the coin and then slather oil and cinnamon on the candle. Of course, if you're allergic to cinnamon, then omit the cinnamon. You don't need the cinnamon. The cinnamon just has these abundance energies, so if you are able to burn it, then go ahead. If you can't, it's fine. Light the candle and hold the intent that the money will come to you. Imagine what you'd do with the money. Of course, make sure it's realistic. And then you drip wax on the envelope to seal it and carry the envelope in your wallet. I altered this spell a lot when I did it. I added my own sigil. I wrote down a ton of names of people that I am inspired by all around, and I manifested money to me that way, so you can do that as well. You guys can always alter spells any way you'd like, and it will still be just as effective as the original spell, maybe even more because you adapted it to your own fitting, and as long as you hold the intent strongly, it will work just as fine. Moving on, I didn't want to make this witch completely obsessed with money, so I gave him another outfit, and that is what I've dubbed the boyfriend outfit. So he's doing a glamour spell before going on his date. I have never done any glamour spells because I'm just not really interested in it, I guess. But I imagine you can use the oils and herbs associated with beauty, love, and lust to create a concoction that will work best for you. Honey is also a great ingredient to sweeten and curry someone's favor with you, so I urge you to try it out. Not only could you use essential oils to make a perfume or put it in your bath, you could also make a honey mojo jar with oils to manifest any romance or money or good luck that you want. And you can search how to do this in books or the internet very easily. Essential oils are fantastic when you have a slight headache or want to relax before going to bed or bring some different energies to your spell work. Despite my rant earlier, I do recommend using them. And these are the ones in my collection. I don't have very many, but they last a long time, so I would say they are definitely worth the price. Just make sure that the product you are getting is genuine and ethically sourced so you won't be scammed. And he's finished! What do you guys think of these witches? Who is your favorite this time? Let me know if you guys have tried these magics out, and I will see you next time. Bye bye. Oh, and I'd really appreciate it if you guys checked out my newest post on Instagram, which is this story art challenge that I have created. So I made this a challenge because I'm a little bored of all these draw this in your style, which I really do like, but it's kind of boring to me, so I wanted to add a story element to my challenge. So basically, what you have to do is draw in the following weeks a continuation of this story and write a mini blurb of the story. Each week will have a prompt, but you can also go off and do your own thing. So I just made this challenge because I'm looking forward to October and Halloween or Samhain, and really looking forward to these autumn creepy energies. So I hope you guys will join me in this challenge. It'll be really fun and I'm excited to see what everyone will make. So yeah. Anyways, that's it for today and see you next week. Goodbye. Bye. I don't really make sigils in my cooking. Remember when I said I make a lot of pasta and soup? Yeah, you can't really make a soup sigil unless you do it with herbs. I don't know. The ABC craft pasta. Thank you.